that's something I just made up in the last hour or so. So I'm going to sort of walk through what it is, because I'm pretty happy with it, and it also, it uses the ENSONIQ TS12 and the OCTATRACK. The OCTATRACK controls the TS12 and does a lot of things with, not so much with parameter locks, but with LFOs and stuff like that, controlling features of the TS12 to give it this sound. So, let's get right into it. So on this, on these four tracks here, I've just got one sound, and it's this sound. So it's a bit of a pad, but I developed it out of these sounds here. They're from the TS12, but they're like the tail of a pad. So I made some chords, and then made some chords, and then I only chopped out the tail, the reverb, and because it's got this nice sort of, if I can turn off all the effects, which I should be able to do using some scenes. So basically, go back here. Still got something going on over here. Yeah, that's the one. Turn all of this off. So that's the basic sound. Pop at the end, but basically I really like the way the tail of that shifts. So I thought I'd make it the basis for something. You can also notice some distortion on this. That's actually because on the filter I've got some distortion happening here. Also, there's a lot of compression happening in some spots, so you do get a bit of digital distortion, which I actually really like on the OCTATRACK, and I use that distortion a lot. So this track is just one track, but then it neighbors into three other tracks. So this whole side is just one sound feeding into more effects. So I've got a filter, a delay, a lo-fi into a compressor, into a phaser, into a delay, into a compressor, into a dark reverb. I don't usually do this much effect stacking, but I wanted to do a lot of things with scenes, and you know, it helps to just bring things in and out. So like the phaser, for example, isn't doing anything unless a scene is operating. Which scene is it? Is this one? So when you play it, but it's also got some delay modulation. It's this one. It's a bit of filter. And some distortion. Got some sample rate reduction. I'm not sure what these ones stand for, but they give it that LFO kind of sound. Or FM kind of sound. And then it feeds into the delay, another delay. Because it's really spaced out sounds. And then this one, it just says delay. Oh, and the phaser, yeah. Anyway. So there's a lot of scenes happening. I set up a whole bunch of scenes, just, you know, give it some variety. And then once I was done with this sound, I then brought in this beat, which is just a sample. Well, it's being affected a little bit as well. Like, I've got some compression and some filtering going on it. But I've also just kind of fucked with it a lot in other areas, like in the pattern and stuff, so... A lot of scenes going on this one as well. I'm pretty happy with the way they sound, actually. It's just a lot of variety, but basically it's a bit of filtering and some compression and some like slowing down the rate and the pitch to give it some crunchiness. They're all sort of variations on the same thing, really, but different degrees and different emphasis. So yeah, like this one. A lot of high pass filtering. So I really liked the way that beat sounded. And then I sort of expanded it into a different beat, which is this one. Which is married to this kick. Which I then layered this kick on top of. So all in all, I'm pretty fucking happy with these beats. I think they sound pretty fucking sweet. And I really like what I've done with the scenes and stuff, so... That's kind of just like a cursory glance at what I did for Savo, but the main reason I wanted to make this video is because of what I've done. I'll turn that on, and I'll turn these on. What I've done with this MIDI track. So this sound is a toy piano sound. It's a preset which I have on the TS12, and I edited it a little bit. I added some effects to it. There's a reverb on there now, but on the reverb, as I'll get to in a minute, I've done some modulations. I've also done some modulations with the filter, and these are linked to... So I've got them set up on the Aftertouch and on CC2, which is also the mod wheel. So basically that just meant, well, not CC2, sorry, is it? Yeah, anyway. So basically just means I can use those control messages to affect things on the TS12. And it sort of brings it to life, as you can hear. And if I go to the LFO page, I've got a bunch of things happening on here. I'll just copy that quickly. If I just turn all of these down, that that's the bass sound. There's no effects or anything. So I'll bring them in one by one. So it's like a bit complicated what I'm doing, but yeah, you can hear the results. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to stop this video, pick up the camera, and take it over the TS12 just so I can show what's going on. Okay, cool. All right, so there's the Octatrack. Now you go around my studio over to the TS12. So over here, what have we got going? So this is the original sound that I used, this toy piano sound. But I modified it and saved it over here. Still sounds similar, but remember on the Octatrack I've got things affecting it, so the effects are coming in and out. So if I go over here, I go to Program Effects. Got this reverb going, and I've modified it a little bit, but the real place I've modified it is in the mod section. And I love this feature of the TS12 that you can modulate the effect. It's really cool. So on this one, I've just got the wheel control messages affecting the mix of the effect, which is nice, the reverb. And then the pressure, or the aftertouch, is affecting the decay time. So you get a nice sort of stuttery kind of pumping kind of sound, which I really like. But then if I go over to the filter, I've got the wheel, the same control message is now affecting the mod amount of the envelope, which just gives these sharp sort of flutters and stuff throughout, which I really like as well. And that's just like scratching the surface. Like, I haven't touched any of the other CC messages. There's a lot of things I could send to this. I haven't really tried yet because it involves like checking what CC messages a lot of these can. Actually, I don't even know if I could do it on the TS12, to be honest. I feel like because the mod sources, there's only so many of them, and none of them are like CC70 or anything like that. They're all sort of their own thing, which is why Aftertouch, Mod Wheel, pitch bend and stuff like that are really obvious ones because they're standard and they show up in the mods. So anyway, let's go back over here to the Octatrack. And yeah, basically, as I've already shown, if I turn the aftertouch up, the reverb's just always on. So that's pretty cool. That's really awesome, I think. The only real problem, I think, with this is you cannot control these with scenes. And I don't know why. That just seems weird to me, because if I can just turn the knob, why can't I just assign that to this? Maybe it would be glitchy, just in the stuttering of the MIDI messages, because I know MIDI is a bit shit. But anyway, that's kind of all I wanted to show with this video. I'll definitely be doing another video very soon, maybe focusing on similar things, because I just really like the marriage of the Octatrack and the TS12. I think that it's just a fun pairing. yeah, so anyway, is all the rest of my shit. May as well have a look at it while we're here. None of it's turned on, none of it's doing anything. And over here I've got my rack and preamp, mixer. There's a circuit that normally lives there, but it's not there at the moment. And all of my posters. Fun times. Anyway, let's turn this around, shall we? So that's it for this video. I'll do one soon, definitely. I'm also going to be getting an Elektron analog heat at some point soon, and probably a Digitact when they come out. So I'll definitely do videos about them for sure. And I've just got more ideas for videos with, you know, all of this stuff, really. So anyway, subscribe, watch, enjoy, tell me what you think. See ya.